The most widely held scientific theory of the origin of the Earth and of the entire solar system was first advanced by the German philosopher Immanuel Kant, and later by French mathematician Pierre-Simon Laplace. They held that the sun and planets condensed from a nebula. Support for this idea came with development of more powerful telescopes and spectrometers, which can detect the composition of material deep in space. Nebula are created by the explosion of stars, which have exhausted their nuclear fuel. By studying the compositions of nebula, astronomers have found evidence that stars and planets can form from these interstellar clouds. 99% of nebular material is composed of hydrogen and helium gas. But about 1% consists of tiny bits of solid matter, silicon compounds, iron oxides, carbon, and a host of other materials, all of which are found in the sun and planets. If the force of gravity between the gas and bits of cosmic dust is strong enough, this matter is gradually pulled together. As the nebula contracts, it starts spinning, with heat setting its particles in motion. The further it condenses, the faster it rotates. The process is something like what happens when a skater condenses himself by drawing in his arms until his body becomes a blur. Gradually, the gas and stardust become more and more concentrated at the center of the nebula, heating up to form a star. The material spinning around a new star flattens into a disk, drawn there by gravity from the equatorial bulge created by the star's rotation. Over tens of millions of years, dust gathers as clumps in the hot disk. These collide and weld together under the influence of gravity, forming larger objects called planetesimals, which in turn come together to form the planets. The precise details of this accretionary process remain unclear. Ultimately, the gases themselves partially crystallize and condense to form balls of ice.
The cloud of material from which the planets formed started out as being mostly gas with a small amount of dust. That dust was very fine indeed. But the particles collided with each other, and during those collisions, they stuck with each other so that material started to coagulate into still bigger bodies. So you have to imagine that we went from dust particles all the way up to objects that were kilometers across. Those objects were colliding with each other, making still bigger bodies. So that we think of the formation of solid planets like the Earth as being a hierarchical process, a process that starts off with very small things, very large in number, towards intermediate-sized things, smaller in number, and eventually ending up with a very small number of large objects. As an intermediate stage in this process, we could imagine that the region where the Earth formed contained hundreds of objects that were about the size of the Earth's moon. Most of those objects then coalesced to make a single planet, the Earth.